And good evening. It's Wednesday, the 4th of January, 2016. Welcome along to another live United Kingdom talk. I can't believe how many live shows we're doing at the moment. I've got an extra night off this week because usually on a Wednesday night, I host a little quiz night at the King's Head Theatre Bar in Upper Street in Islington. But that's not on tonight because we didn't think anyone would come. What, we're being so close to the New Year's Eve and everything. So that's the reason why that's not happening tonight. You'll be able to call in a little bit later, boys and girls. I've got some things for you to call in about tonight as well. Just a few suggestions a little bit later, OK? Let's say hello to some early people that are with us tonight. Good morning, good evening. It's good evening tonight. Have a look at the clock, OK? See that clock there? Can you see that over there? You can't see that one. Can you see that one? Can you see anything? Hello? Are we there? If it's 7:30... on Wednesday, the 4th of January, 2007. Did I say 2017 at the beginning? I might have said the wrong date. That would be the first time I've slipped into that one. Who is still saying 2016? You are, aren't you? Yes, I know. You are still saying 2017 to 16, aren't you? It's 2017, OK? So if it's just gone 7:30, Wednesday, the 4th of January, 2017, UK time... If that's the time where you are now, we are live. If it's any other time, you're watching a recording, a little recording of our worldwide famous television spectacular known as United Kingdom Talk. Let's say hello to some early people today. Shania is on the Isle of Wight. Greetings, Shania. Joey's with us. Good evening, Joey. Daniel Gannon up in Manchester is with us tonight. Mark's with us in the Arsenal. Good evening, Mark. All right. Lily's with us. Good evening, Lily. And Sean Michael Trabtree is with us this evening. Good evening. Best part of the night is clock down. Now, what does that mean? Best, I don't understand that. Best part of the night is clock down. Well, you've got me on that one, dear. What does that mean, clock down? What, you want me to put the clock down? Don't understand. Please explain what you mean there, dear. We don't know. Mark says we need to make a song for the intro. Do you not get the music when the countdown is happening? I better check that with you. Do you watch, you know, when the countdown's happening? You should get music while that's happening. Are you telling me you're not getting any music? We can't be replacing the music with a song. That's a nice piece of music, that is. Don't ask. Well, I do know what it is, but I cannot reveal what it is for copyright reasons. No idea where that came from, are you? No, you would do. You might know where that music's come from if you live in the Midlands. There's a clue. The clue is in the question. If you're in the Midlands, you might know where that's coming from, OK? So do let us know if you can hear the music when the countdown's happening before we start. Good evening to Brandon. Hello, Brandon, who says, love the opening of your show. Thank you, Brandon. We've got a very good closing as well, Brandon. Brandon was, he's in London at the moment, and he was hoping to come to one of my karaoke's. Brandon and his other half, oh gosh, it's gone out of my head now. Oh, no. Well, I cannot remember your other half's name. That's gone right out of my head. That is. I'm sorry. Oh gosh. You're never going to forget. You'll never forgive me for that, will you? I can't remember the name of your other half. Hang on, let me try and look it up. Have you attached yourself to him? You should. Brandon, just a moment, please. Let's see if I can find this for you. Oh, dear. I hope he's not watching. I shall never live again. Well, I will be possibly destroyed. We do like to remember names. Here we are. There we are. Brandon. Stefano. That's it. No, I didn't see the name. Didn't see the name. It came to me very quickly then. It came to, from outer space. I was sent messages from outer space, boys and girls. Yes. Oh, someone wants to be my friend. Hello, friend. Sorry about that. Okay. Sorry about that. All right. So Brandon wanted to know if there was any karaoke. Unfortunately, no. Not till Friday. I'm only doing one karaoke at the moment. I gave up two jobs towards the end of last year. One became very quiet. That was the one in Sydenham. And I said to the boss, look, I know it's really quiet. If you want to give this a hit on the head, then that's fine by me. He said, are you sure? I said, yes. He said, when do you want? I said, anytime. He said, do it next week then. Make next week your last one. So that was fine. And the other one was another place. Where they kept having little scuffles in there. Not with me, little scuffles in there. And I felt a little bit uneasy about that. There didn't seem to be anyone to sort it out. Do you know what I mean? And when you're standing there with, you know, a few thousand pounds worth of gear, you don't want that sort of thing. So that's the other one. I left that as well. So the only karaoke I'm doing at the moment is... Oh, no, actually, I do two, don't I? I do Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross, Brandon. That's on Monday from 8 o'clock with cheap drinks and Friday from 8:30. All right. And I also do occasional one at a place called the Corner House in Maidenhead. Unfortunately, I believe you're going home Thursday, so it's too you're going home too early. Can't you stay another day? As they say in E17, stay another day, stay another day. Something like that, is it? I don't know. Perhaps you could sing that song for us, Brandon. Thank you. Hello to Dave Moses. Hello, Dave. Dave, I saw... I was actually watching it last night. I got into bed. I wasn't late last night, but about 1 o'clock in the morning. And I saw your post of the audio recording of the gallery for some phone numbers show, which I listened. Oh, my God. It was hilarious. Hilarious. If I can just explain what that is, boys and girls, some of you won't know what the hell I'm talking about here. The gallery recording of a TV show. OK, so you know when you see a TV show. There's also a gallery where the producer and other input, vision mixer, sound mixer, they all sit in this room, okay? And all the TV cameras are all coming into this room and the sound and all the microphones come into this room. And a bloke sits there pushing buttons, okay? Camera one, camera two. Now, it's much more complicated than that, but just, you know, basically that's what happens. Someone, oh, that microphone there... You know, and let's put the captions on, things like that all the time. Now, the people in the gallery talk to each other and to the presenter, to the live presenter on the show, which in this case happened to be Philip Schofield, who's just a total a professional, isn't he? Whatever you throw at Philip Schofield, he can do. I think he's fantastic. He really is a fantastic presenter. And what we got was the recording of the audio that was going between all the people in the gallery and him as well. And things were going wrong. It was hilarious. The swearing that went on. Oh, my God. My ears were bleeding. That they were bleeding more than at my karaoke nights, I have to say. They were bleeding listening to this highly amusing video audio recording. So, if you ever have a look on YouTube at some of this gallery recording, BBC or something like that, you will find some of those recordings that someone's put up there. And they really are very, very amusing. There was one point where it was supposed to be a live show. But on live shows, it's not necessary that everything is live. Sometimes they might have a singer on, for example, you know. And they might say, OK, and now we're going to have a singing for you this evening, One Direction. Then you see at home One Direction. But that part of it could have been recorded in the afternoon. Maybe they weren't available or something like that, you know. And there was a part of it where they had a recording which, you know, was part of the live show. So you shouldn't have realised that it wasn't part of the live show. And all of a sudden, it went into fast forward. And they were going mad. They were going mad to each other in this gallery. But what a wonderful... And Dave wants to do that. Dave, who's watching us this evening, he also runs a community radio station, Hebden Radio. Which I'm not quite sure where it is. It's up where it's further north than here. But I think it's further north than here. So he's very busy. And he wants to do... He wants to work in that live television. I mean, you're bound to have a heart attack by 40, Dave. If you do. Oh, maybe you are 40 already, are you, lovey? Are you 40 already? I mean, I've had a look at your pictures and you seem to be aging very quickly. Unlike me, look, I still look like I'm 25 sitting here, don't I? How marvellous. Thank you, Dave. Lovely to hear from you. And thank you so much for posting that. There's a lot more on there. After I watched that, I was clicking through to another few of those gallery audio things. They are hilarious, really hilarious. Hello to Mary Wright, karaoke show extraordinaire. Hello to Lily, who's having her dinner at the moment. What are you having today, Lily? Lily bought us in some authentic Philippine, is it Philippine or Filipino? Philippines. I'm not sure how you would say that. bought us in some food that would be eaten in the Philippines the other day. It's a little pastry thing she bought in on Friday night, didn't you, my darling? I couldn't eat all of mine because lovely Maureen, as you know, she brings me a little packed lunch every Monday and Friday, a little box with salads in it and crisps and things like that. I have had to request, and chocolate and cakes. I have had to request, I sent a nice request to Maureen, asking her to knock out the chocolate and the crisps for a while because we've got to lose a bit of weight, dear. About a stone and a half. You know, I've got to lose a little bit of weight, about a stone. No one's told me to lose weight. You know, it's funny. Most people who you say, oh, I'm a bit fat, and they say, you're not fat, Chris. I am, dear. 13 and a half stone. It's not good. I've got beautiful jackets from Ted Baker. That I mean, I can't do... Look what happens if I try and do this up. Look what happens if I try and do this up. Look. Ooh. Look. Right, you ready? I'll let it out now. It doesn't work, does it? It really doesn't work. So we need to lose a little bit of weight. I tell you what, I've come in here and I've turned this central heating on in my house, in my studio, sorry, in my purpose-built television studio. And it's getting a bit hot in here, to be honest. Hello to John Coops. Hello, John C. Hope you're well. Peter Hyde is stuck on the M11 in traffic. Oh, no. So you're listening. Don't watch us, dear. I hope you're not watching your phone while you're driving. Just have it listen. Turn the phone up the other way. Yes. Oh, talking of Ted Baker, by the way, if you like the Ted Baker stuff and Ralph Lauren, designer labels, a lot of the stuff is 50% off at the moment. So you've got some good deals in there. I love the Ted Baker stuff. I really do. All my jackets are Ted. All of them are Ted Baker. Except bar one. No, two. One's Burton's. That's the light blue coloured one. And one is Ralph Lauren, which is the sort of linen one that you can. Oh, I don't know about linen. I don't think I'll buy another linen jacket. No, because it's always looked like it needs to be ironed. I know it's supposed to look like that, but I'm not keen. I like it to look a bit sharper. Talking of sharpness, I need to cut my hair again this week. And I still haven't had a chance to use this yet. This is Bald Spot Blackener, which my lovely niece gave me, which I'm going to test out on my head before one of my gigs. And I shall see if anyone notices. Oh, there's no need to be serious about anything. Mark says, Sunday night karaoke is difficult with people going to work on Mondays for people. Yeah, it is. But I don't. We're not quite sure why that one died, to be honest. It started off fairly well, actually. It didn't take long to build up. And we built up. And then for a good 9 months, we had a busy Sunday night. And then all of a sudden, it just died. And I don't think anyone was going anywhere else. And, you know, you kind of start wondering if it was you or not. But sometimes the trouble is with karaoke nights, they can become a victim of their own success. Obviously, with a karaoke night, the more people that come to sing, not everyone comes to sing. Some people just like to come and watch. But the more people that come to sing, the less amount that they will sing. You see, so as it got busier and busier, these people that... would have sung four or five, six times a night, suddenly could only sing two or three times. And sometimes that, and then they don't come again because they can't sing enough. On the other hand, you don't want a quiet karaoke night. Let's be honest, you're singing for other people to see you. You're not just singing for yourself, are you? You want other people to see you singing. That's why you've come. That's what it's all about. So if you're there on your own and you're singing 20 times, that's no fun either. So there's a kind of midway range, something like that, Mark, I think. Now, this is interesting. Shania, you must have something wrong with your computer, Mark. Shania said she does hear the music, OK, when the countdown is happening. Look, I'll put it on again for a second. If you're watching the recording, you won't get this. Just have a look at this for a second. Hang on, where is it now? Is that it? Hang on a minute. Is that it there? There it is. That you see? Right? I can put the music up, actually. Can you not hear that music, Mark? See? Did you get that then? Can you not hear that music? I can't understand why you can't hear that music. Shania could hear it. Joey could hear it. Oh, yes. Everyone can hear it. So, and Dave says it's very professional. Come on, Dave. Professional? Me? That's why I'm not on these radio stations here, dear. Because I'm not professional. I'm too thick to be on somewhere like LBC. Oh, how boring is that? Politics and train strikes and all that. Oh, no, we want a bit more fun than that. That's why I'm sitting here doing it off my own thing, off my own back there. Okay, now a couple of things. If you want to call in, oh, should we do a couple of more messages before we do that? Okay. Mark says, oh, no, my phone was playing up. I can hear it now. I see, it's your fault, Mark. You want to get yourself, oh, yeah, you've got that phone that interferes with my stuff at work, haven't you? Now, I can't remember. What phone have you got, Mark? He's got this mobile phone. And if I'm doing karaoke, okay, when he turns up at a karaoke, I've got radio mic. I take one radio mic with me and I take one lead mic. I've had the radio mic years and years ago. I bought it from Mark. I think it was Marquee Audio. Did me a very good deal on the price. It's got to be about 10 years old. I bought it just as they changed the frequencies. And for some reason, whenever Mark puts his phone down, because he likes to record himself and he does a bit of live stuff as well when he's doing his singing, when he puts his phone down, it interferes with the radio mic and it starts playing up. And his is the only phone that does it. You haven't got one of those exploding phones, have you, Mark? We don't want bits of Mark all over the pub, dear. What a terrible mess. God's sake. Thank you, Mark. Hello to Diane. Hello, Diane. Long time no see. One of my clubbing friends, aren't you? Well, it's a long time ago now, isn't it, Diane? We used to you used to go to trade with me, I think. I think you went to trade as well, didn't you? Happy New Year. Not happy birthday. Happy birthdays later on. Happy New Year, Diane. Mark wants to know, what's your views on Celebrity Big Brother? Please don't waste our time talking about Celebrity Big Brother. None of us here watch that programme. It is trash television. We have no interest in that whatsoever, I'm afraid. None at all. I've no idea who's on it. I don't want to know who's on it. And it's absolutely rubbish television. Please put on David Attenborough one more time in place of Big Brother. Bring back Dallas. Bring back Dallas to replace Celebrity or normal Big Brother. Not that any of them are normal, are they? I bet they're all mouthy and that. I can't stand mouthy people who just go on and on for hours chatting. Hello to Simon Keane, who says, good evening, Mr. Chop Chop. You're not fat. I am, dear. I'm 13 and a half stone. I should be 12 stone, I'm sure. Look, I can feel it. When I roll over in bed, I know that those springs are becoming dented in there. And in my new bed. I've got to lose the weight so I don't wear out the new bed. Terrible. Dave Moses says he's 31, dear. Oh, really? Really? And you moisturise? Well, put a bit more on, my love. You want to put a bit more moisturiser on there? I use bio oil. Can you tell that? Bio oil. That's what I've got on my face. Bio oil. Good evening to Tom Harris in Chicago. We had someone from Chicago turned up at the karaoke on Monday and Friday last. He was lovely. His name was Ron. And what a wonderful singer he was. Him and his friend. Can't remember his friend because I didn't fancy him. I just fancied Ron. You only remember the ones that you fancy, don't you? Yes. Hello to Kiki D, who's with us this evening. Rod Brown is there as well. I must say, I'm very surprised. I thought, oh, I'm taking a bit of a risk here, you know, going on at 7:30 at night. Oh, blimey, 15 minutes already? Where's that gone? Where's that gone? I haven't taken a breath yet. Right, here's the next 20 minutes. I must say, I'm very surprised we've got so many people with us today. At this time, we've got the EastEnders and the Coronation Street and Emmerdale on, haven't we? Emmerdale Farm. Da, 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 da. I'm so old. I knew Emmerdale Farm when it was a shed. Put it that way. It used to be just a shed. Emmerdale Farm. Oh, beautiful. Da, 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 da. I used to have another soap that I used to like the music to. Take the High Road from Scottish television. Do you remember that one? Do you remember that? Oh, it was lovely. The scenery is beautiful. The acting was dire, but it didn't matter. You see the Scottish Highlands and everything. That must be about 20 years ago now. Anyone remember that? Take the High Road. Yes. Let's say hello to Joanna. Oh, here's something for you to think about first. Think about this first, okay? Now, I had a dream this afternoon. And I want to know if you've had any unusual dreams. Any that really stick in your mind. perhaps they've been there for years ago, years and years, stuck in your little old heads. And I always have a couple of hours sleep in the afternoon, you see. Because I work at night, so I have that 2 hours sleep in the afternoon, keeps me a little bit fresh for later on. So, this dream, which I wrote, you must write down your dreams quickly, otherwise they're gone. They're gone. Now, so, let me just have a cough. That's better. I've got a cough button here, Dave. Very, very professional. Cough button, dear, cough button. So, this dream, I remember being in some sort of supermarket, and the lady before me, for some reason, I was going through the till before I'd actually been in the supermarket. So there was a lady at the till. We was kind of blocking up. Oh, come on, get out of the way. You know, get out of the way. She was being mucking around at the till, you know. So that was that. OK, I then walked at this girl who was in another queue, spoke to me. She said, "You're Chris, aren't you?" I said, "Yes." Says, "Oh, hello." I said, "Hello." She said, "You don't remember me, do you?" I said, "Well, no. Were you at school with me?" And she said, "Yes." I said, "Well, you can't have been. You don't look as old as I am." I'm 53, incidentally, Buzzing. She didn't. She looked about 42, about 10 years younger than me. She said, "No, I was at school with you." And I'm looking at this girl, and I couldn't remember who it was. Anyway, that's as much as I know about that bit, right? And then I'm standing around a pool table, which is also in this supermarket. Now, it was a Morrison's, but it didn't look like a Morrison's. It looked like a large but private corner shop. So a very large but private corner shop. But there was a pool table in there. And I was standing around this pool table, and there was a priest from when I was a child, Father Symes. And Father Symes was a very short man, not much hair, little glasses like that. And he never needed a microphone when he was doing the church stuff. He had a really loud voice, not just for talking, for singing as well. You could hear him at the back of the church, even when the microphones weren't working. And he came over to me. He said, "Hello, Chris." I said, "Oh, Father Son, thank you so much for coming to see me." And he died many, many years ago, right? And he is also still dead in this dream of mine that I've just had just 2 hours ago. This was 2 hours ago. And I said to Father Sumps, "Oh, thank you so much for coming to see me." I said, "I can't believe it. Thank you, thank you, thank you." He said, "That's all right." I said, "So tell me, Father, what is it like in heaven?" I said, is time the same? I said, "Because, you know, you've now been gone, oh my gosh, 28 years or something like that." I said, "Is it the same? So it's like, you know, 7:30 here now. If you went, when you go back to heaven," I assumed, you know, assumed he was going back to heaven at some point, "what time would it be there now? Or is it a completely different thing?" And he didn't answer this. I don't remember him saying anything else to me. And then I said, "Did you ever go back to St. Joseph's after you'd left?" And he said, "No." He didn't say, he said, no, he hadn't been back to the church. The one that I grew up with years ago in Roehampton, St. Joseph's Church in Roehampton. And he said, no, he never went back. And I held back on saying, "Oh, well, it's not the same, you know, since you were there. We had another priest and another couple of priests since then." I don't go to that church now. But I know there were a couple of priests there. And it's never the same when someone, it doesn't have to be a priest, it could be a teacher, somebody works in a shop, and you go there and they're not there anymore. And it's never quite the same, is it? Let me see. That's it. And that was my dream, really. And I woke up. I woke up while Father Symes was talking to me in this dream, really pleased that he'd come and visited me in this dream. So that was my dream. And I'm wondering, boys and girls, have you got any dreams in your memory that you want to talk about with me tonight? There is a phone number. Now, if you're watching the show live, a number will now appear on your TV and computer screens as if by magic in yellow. There it is. You can call in either on the phone. We have a local London number. It's not a premium rate number. There's none of this £1.50 a minute lark or anything like that. It's a normal local London number. The phone number is 020-8144-3477. Okay, once again, 020-8144-3477. If you're watching a recording of the show, there's no phone number. Please don't call in. No one's going to answer you. All right? So once again, the phone number. Tell me about your dream. It's 020-8144-3477. If you have Skype, you can also Skype in, boys and girls. We have the Skype set up and running lovely. Free calls from all over the world. The Skype in is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Okay, Skype in on United Kingdom Talk. Finally, as I found out yesterday, you can now also Facebook call in. If you're watching this via Facebook Live, which most of you are, then you can use the call button on Facebook. Have a little look around for that. I'm sure you'll find it, okay? Just simply use the call button on Facebook and you should come up there and you'll be able to call in like that as well. So any of those three methods. Alternatively, if you want to just sit there and listen to me rabbit around, rabbiting on for another, I don't know, for another 45 minutes or so, that's fine as well. You don't have to call in if you don't want to. Or you can send me a message about your dreams and I'll happily read it out for you, boys and girls, okay? Email address as well, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk is my email address. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk email address. So I'd love to hear your dreams. Perhaps you think that dream is significant in some way. In what way do you think that, does that dream mean anything? You know, because sometimes I think about dreams, does that mean anything? Now, interestingly enough, I was just told a few hours ago that a very dear lady friend of mine had died just before Christmas. Her name was Grace, and she lives not too far away from here. Now, the way I met her, I was in hospital 1999, I think it was, with a burst appendix. And they fixed that. And they said I'd recover quickly because I have a very low heartbeat rate. Because I do a lot of exercise, swimming and all that, I have quite a low heartbeat rate, sometimes as low as 52, 55. Normal is about 70-odd, somewhere around the 70s. Mine is quite low because I do a lot of exercise. Okay, if you smoke, you could be in the hundreds. It's not good to have a banging heart, you know, going very quickly over 100. If you smoke, that's likely to be the case. I mean, do your pulse now. Tell me your pulse rate this evening. Mine's usually, when I go to bed, sometimes I do my pulse. Actually, I've got a little app on my phone. We do like apps, don't we? I've got this little heart monitor thing. And you put your finger on the camera and the light comes on. And it measures your heart rate. And sometimes I do that before I go to bed. You know, get one final check of Facebook messages before we go to bed. We all do it, don't we, eh? You all do it. But then I turn my phone off. I think it's bad to have your mobile phone switched on, sitting on your bedside cabinet. I mean, the waves are going through. I even come in here sometimes and turn the Wi-Fi off, you know, just to give my head a little bit of a rest from all the waves going all over the place. Do you do that as well? How mad is that? So that's what I do there. Anyway. Grace, I met in the hospital. they fixed my appendix, but then things started to go wrong, and I had to have a small bag, not a wee bag, you know, a little drain bag. So it was only small, and that was attached to where my appendix had been, and this was filling up with stuff. Oh, nasty, nasty. Oh, you're sorry, Lily. You're having your dinner, aren't you, darling? Let's talk about something else. and it started worrying me. And this elderly lady, Grace, just came and spoke to me. And she was so nice. And she helped me through that. And then over the next, 15, 16, 17 years, I would ring her up few times a year, then that'd become once a year. And then I don't suppose I've spoken to her for about a year and a half, 2 years now. And sometimes I would go round to her house after this hospital thing, as the years went on. I'd go round to her house and she'd cook a dinner and we'd sit there, just me and her, near her, at the back of her house where the garden was. We'd look out of her window and she liked a wild garden. That doesn't mean it was uncared for and messy. Well, I suppose it was messy, really. We're not talking rubbish in the garden. You just let it grow. You just let it grow naturally. And I really like that. I really like that. Indeed, there's a part of my garden in the corner that I don't really do anything to. I just let it go because I quite like that wildness. And then as the years went by, I suppose the phone calls from me, it was always me who made the phone call. I think she'd rung me just a couple of times. But the phone calls became less. And I don't suppose I've spoken to her now for about a year and a half, maybe 2 years. And I found out today that she had died. And I was quite taken aback by that. I was, oh, you know how you are when you're quite shocked and not necessarily so shocked when someone is quite that old. I think she was either approaching or in her 80s now. So that's a fair age to be, isn't it? And I was quite shocked by this, and I kind of shut up for a while and thought about it. Anyway, so I was told that today, and that's interesting how the priest has appeared in my dream today. But no mention of Grace or anyone like that. I just wish I'd have known. She died just before Christmas, apparently. Which is very sad, but a lovely lady. Her name's Grace. She was also known, I don't know why I called her Grace. I think she was known by two names, Grace and also Joyce as well. Lovely lady. So rest in peace to that lady. Any dreams that you want to tell me about? Then call in 020-8144-3477. You can Skype in. United Kingdom Talk is my Skype. Or you can Facebook call in as well. If you know how to do that, then do that, all right? Let's go to some of your messages, boys and girls. Hello to Kiki D, who says, oh, I've got that app. I checked mine in bed, and she's 65. Oh, 65 heart rate, Kiki D. You're not very fit, are you, darling? Actually, 65 is still below the average. Okay, I think the average is about 72, so you're not doing bad, Kiki D. You must be doing something, darling. Good evening to Ray Reynolds, who's with us tonight. Ray Reynolds, international ukulele player, and he's cleaning windows. Ray Reynolds is with us. John Charles says, should it not be zero and not O when giving the number out? Ah, well, some people say zero, some people say O. Thank you for pointing out a little thing, John. Just a tiny little thing. Why does it matter to you that it's O or zero? But just for your benefit, dear, if you want to call in, it's 020. It doesn't flow. Zero doesn't flow. It doesn't flow. 020-8144-3477 doesn't sound as good as 020-8144-3477. You must surely agree with that, John. Because I am right in that, my darling. I'm generally right in everything. That is a fact. That is written down somewhere, John. 020-8144-3477 is the number. Oh, and by the way, if you're going to call in, please watch out for the swearing tonight, dear. Now, we had a little bit of swearing last night from the callers, which wasn't intentional. I'll give you that. It wasn't intentional. You know, it's like sometimes I think when people are talking to you on the phone, it's it is just like talking to you in person, isn't it? Whether we're doing this show or not. And it's easy to forget or something like that, you know. So do be a little bit careful when you're talking. If you accidentally swear, I probably won't cut you off. But if you just ring in and say, then you will. Disconnected and banned from this worldwide television programme. Thank you. Simon says, fat means fabulous. Take talking. Thank you. Is that what it means? F-A-T. That means fabulous at talking. John says, where are you tonight? In my Mirrorball studio, John. In the Mirrorball studio in Royal Berkshire, dear. Hello to Rod Brown, who says, the soaps are not real anymore. I know. I've watched them. I've watched some. I mean, I don't watch soaps unless you include Casualty and Holby City as soaps. I suppose you could really, because they're in every week. Oh, did you see Holby City last night? Mo's had the baby. You know Mo? She's the big girl. She's my favourite character in that. Mo in Holby City. She's had the baby and she's told the other bloke that it's his. Because the other bloke was going to get married to some woman and the other woman pretended that she was having a baby. But it was all found out, dear. And of course, the woman, the mother of the bloke who was getting married, found out. And then she picked up the microphone in her drunken state and announced it to everyone. Oh, it was fab. It was fab. Anyway, Rod says the soap's not real anymore. I remember Ina Sharples on Coronation Street with her hairnet. Oh, I remember that. I remember good old Ina Sharples. Now, in all the soaps, the ladies have £200 hairstyles, or the men's have fake tans. If this carries on the vet on Emmerdale, we want your head hair paint. I'm going to try this one night and see if anyone notices. Ray Reynolds will be looking for this every time now he comes along to one of my gigs. I'll have to do it when I come out because it just makes your head feel a bit funny. But, you know, I'm thinking that I might be able to use this, Rod, in other situations. Now, I used to go to a lovely little club called Chariots. I don't know if you know that, my darling. A lovely little club called Chariots. But I have a feeling, you know, if I wore it in that steamy environment, it might start running down my face. Or in the swimming pool. What if I go to the swimming pool? What if I forget to have the shower? Because you must have a shower before you get in the swimming pool. Oh, disgusting people who don't have showers and swimming pool. They really are awful. And generally, you can see the dirt oozing off or out of them. I'm sorry, you're still having your dinner, aren't you, Lily? You can see the dirt oozing out of the people as they go in the swimming pool when they haven't had a shower, external and internal as well. I think people should be forced to have internal clear outs before they go in that swimming pool. Disgusting people, yes. But what if I, you know, I might put this on the night, I go to bed, I get up in the morning. If I forget to have a shower before I go in the pool, I'm in there. There would be this black trail of stuff behind me, wouldn't there? Has anyone tried anything like this? Covering up their bald spots, eh, Rod? Hello to Dan Ellis says, keep your dreams to yourself. There's no rudeness in my dreams. Not with a Catholic priest. Thank you, Father. What would Father Symes say? He was a lovely man, Father Symes. Oh, he was such a nice... He was my favourite priest. And when he died, it was all very, very sad. Very, very sad. Daniel in Camberley. Hello, Daniel says, sons and daughters. Do you remember that? I can sing you the theme tune. La da 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 da. Sons and daughters. Yes, Australian show that was. Hated it. Hated it. And what was the war one? Or was that Sons and Daughters? There was an Australian war one. Was that Sons and Daughters? Can't remember now. Can't remember now. Mark says Corey is not on. EastEnders. Oh, I beg your pardon. Okay. Daniel says, it's not your weight that will wear out your bed. I'm sure it will. There's been no visitors to my new bed and I've had it for months now. No visitors. Not even fleas get in that bed with me. Isn't that unbelievable? Hello to Terry H, who says, I'm so behind. Two live shows, too much to catch up on. Well, I can always do less if you want me to, Terry. Oh, are you saying there's too much of me now, dear? We'd just like to have a little chat with each other, that's all. Yes, just a second. Let me just refresh that. Don't like to miss anyone out, my darlings. Daniel says, I had a dream I shot Barry Manilow. Oh, that's not funny, dear. That is not funny, dear. If I had heard that, I would personally come round and have to murder you. That would happen, I'm afraid. I'm saying it. Oh, God, my God. What if Daniel tonight now gets murdered? I would be the first suspect, wasn't I? The police... Excuse me. You mentioned on your... Good morning, sir. Sorry to trouble you. You mentioned on your show that you were going to murder someone. Is there any truth in this incident? It might be a bit like that, mightn't it? Very, very worrying indeed. Very worrying indeed, yes. Joey says, it won't work with me, Chris. I am bald. Yeah, but you're happy, aren't you? You're happy. Some people are happy with having no hair. It doesn't bother me. It does. It does. So what we need to do is paint our head black and take a knife and cut off. Cut off this spare tyre and sell it to a fish and chip shop who can use it, who can melt it down and cook people's chips in Chris Reardon's fat. Do you think there would be a call for that, you know, if that was advertised, chips cooked in Chris Reardon's fat? I reckon there would be queues around the chip and fish and chip shop of people desperate to have some chips cooked in the fat of Chris Reardon. Just a suggestion. Just a suggestion. John says, worse still, someone using your bath and scum lines left after. Oh, how disgusting. I don't have a bath here, John. No bath here. I've just got a I've got a power shower, which is actually about 20 years old now, and it's still working fine. Not that it's used very much. I usually generally use the shower at the swimming pool. What happens, I get up in the morning, I might record a show or I have my breakfast, then I walk up to the pool, and that's my shower of the day. I only have one shower a day. Do you? How many showers do you have? Do you have more than one shower or what? Interesting. Interesting. Simon says, ring 0208181. I think you're just being awkward now. 020. Now, good. Hello tonight to Elaine. Elaine's with us this evening. Good evening, Elaine, in Israel. Ray Reynolds says you could try colour mousse on your hair, or mousse, or mouse might be better. What, a mouse? I saw a mouse. Where? There on the stair. Where on the stair? Right there. A little mouse with clogs on. Well, I declare. Going clip-clippity-clop on the stair. Oh, yeah. I do that one at karaoke. And then Adam the Plumber turned up the other day and did it. People taking my songs like that. Rod says, the Aussie War Soap. Was it the Yes, that's it. Thank you, Rod. The Aussie War Soap was the Sullivans. Remember the music to that then? And you get that thing come up at the end, a Grundy production. I remember it all like it was yesterday. Do you, Rod? You're of an age as well, I think, aren't you, Rod? You must remember all these things, yes. And Kylie Minogue was in that. Was Kylie Minogue in the Sullivans? Was she? I know she was in Neighbours. My God, she must have been really young to be in the Sullivans. Yeah, Ray says the Sullivans. Yeah, it was the Sullivans, wasn't it? That Aussie war thing. Yes, indeed. Elaine says you guys have the weirdest nursery rhymes. We like nursery rhymes. Mouse lived in it. Well, do you want me to sing the whole thing? You don't want me to sing the whole thing, do you? Not today, dear. Not today. I had an unusual charge on my telephone bill. Now, I'm with the Three, THREE. I'm with the Three telephone network. And it's £30 a month. And that's all in. As many calls as you want, as many texts as you want, and as much data as you want. There's no limit on the data. Not only that, it's a fantastic deal. I think the price of that's gone up now, actually. I don't know what it is now, but I'm still on £30. They haven't put what I don't know why they haven't put mine up. I think if you sign up for 30, you stay on the 30 for a period of time, maybe, or something like that. And I can also use it in a list of a very long list of countries at the same rate as that I'm on. So if I went to France in November, didn't I, to the Euro Disney. Very expensive there. Very, very, very extortionately expensive there if you're buying stuff, you know, food and all that business. Anyway, and I'm able to use my phone there and it didn't cost me any more. It still only cost me £30 a month. How fantastic is that? Anyway, so the bill come just a couple of days ago and there's a £10 charge on it. And it just says £10 charge to, where is it now? One moment, please. Here it is. There's a £10 charge to a number 65023. And I don't know what that is. I've no idea what it is. And it was made on the 3rd of December. So it's not that long ago. I would imagine I would remember if I'd typed in such an unusual number. So I went back through my numbers that I had dialed. And, you know, sometimes you get the old text messages sent and you've got a list, haven't you, of all those. And I couldn't find it anywhere. Anyway, I rang up the telephone company 3 and spoke to a man. It sounded like he was in India. Very helpful was this bloke, okay, in India. Oh, we've got a call coming in. Who's that there?
Ray from Morrison's.
Who is it?
Ray Bolasco.
Hello, Ray. All right. Ray, can I just come to you in a minute? If you stay holding on the line there, I'll be to you in a minute. All right?
Thank you much.
Okay, stay there. Anyway, he was really, really helpful. I mean, really went out of his way to try and sort out this problem. And eventually he found out it was a company called M-Gage. And he seems to think it might have been a donation I made to them for some sort of charity. And I'm thinking, do you know what? I think I did make a donation to a charity, but not in December. It was a much, much longer time than that. I would have seen something on the telly, you know. I don't know. Polar bears in the Arctic who are being shot or starving children somewhere else, you know. I think I've seen something on the telly, and I seem to remember. And all you have to do is type a number, and then that donates money to them. And I remember doing it, and I've only ever done it once. I've only done it once, okay? But I'm sure it wasn't in December, so I don't know where this has come from. Anyway, they gave me a number. They found out who the company was. They give me a number to ring, and I cannot get... Do you think I can get through to this company? So we need to stop it happening again. And again, they rung again this morning, the 3 people, to see if I was able to get on. And I have to say, the service from the 3 network was fantastic. Now, I had dealing with them about 25 years ago when they first started, and they were dreadful. They were dreadful, the 3 network then, but they really do seem to have got their customer service together. And I'm so impressed with that. And I don't know who it is that I've donated money to. But just before I came on to do the show today, one of the things that they suggested I did was to text the number again. And they said, this will cost me 10 pence. OK, thank you. And to text stop all to the number. So stop space all space 65023. And they said that should stop it happening again. So I did do that. And interestingly, when I typed in 6, you know, when the mobile phone, it brings you up, like, if you type in a 6, and everything that you've ever typed in, starting with 6, comes up, yeah? So I typed in 65, and up came the rest of the number. So I must have texted something to someone at some point, but I don't know who. Isn't that mad? And I think I have a terrible feeling I've set up, like, a repeat prescription type thing, or whatever it's called. Repeat subscription thing. I've got a terrible feeling. So I typed this stop all, and we'll see what happens, and hopefully... Hopefully that will stop that happening. But I have to say, excellent, excellent service from the 3 telephone network. Okay, let's go to the phone then. And Ray's calling in now. Ray works in Morrison's. Hello, Ray.
So I haven't seen much this year, so I thought I'd see how your New Year was.
And Happy New Year to you. Did you go out New Year, Ray? You're in London. Whereabouts in London are you?
I'm at home in Stanmore.
In Stanmore. Oh, that's Is that classed as Middlesex or London?
Middlesex.
Because a lot of people, some people say Middlesex doesn't exist anymore, don't they?
It depends. But old-fashioned people still call it Middlesex.
Old-fashioned like us, right, yeah?
We're not old-fashioned. We've been around a bit, you and me.
That is so true. That is so true. Well, Happy New Year to you, Ray. Where did you go New Year's Eve? Anywhere?
Nowhere exciting. I was coming down to see you, but my friends from work wanted to go to a pub in Hull.
In where, sorry? Where?
My friends wanted to go to Yates in Harrow because they were leaving to, but it never actually happened, so we just went out for a drink there instead.
Okay, so you didn't actually go to a club then, you just went out for a drink. Did you yeah. stay very late or you ran
yeah,
early?
Yeah, I stayed about 2 o'clock in the morning. The music was too loud, it wasn't party music.
Oh, wasn't it? What sort of music was it in there then?
Bang bang music, you know, really loud.
What, like heavy metal or house or what?
Kind of house. I didn't enjoy it.
No. No, you see, Ray, I'll be honest to you, I don't go out at all anymore. I have no interest whatsoever in going to clubs or indeed pubs, really. I don't like going to pubs. If I didn't work in London, I wouldn't be going into London anymore. And isn't that a real turnaround into what we used to have on a Saturday night at the Black Cap? We were there till 3 a.m. I was DJing and you were dancing.
I miss the dolly mixes and everyone doing their bit like New Year's Eve.
Yes, of course you do. But you remember, you know, even during the rest of the year, forget New Year's Eve, we'd be there till 3 a.m. I'd be playing the records, you'd be dancing on the stage.
I mean, imagine if I looked at the halfway and seen you at Central and go to Abel Duncan, they're not the same.
No, it's not. But, you know, things move on. And even if the Black Cat was to reopen, I mean, there's a wonderful group of people that are doing their best to try and get it to reopen.
But I go when I can to help them, you know that.
I know. But even if it was to reopen, you know it couldn't be the same again because that time has passed now, you know.
The trouble with the Black Cat, they need to spend a lot of money inside and out on it. Make it better access for disabled as well.
Well, it would cost a fortune. If I can just explain to people, the Black Cap is a gay pub that closed almost 2 years ago now. And it's now a closed building. It's ridiculous, really. In the middle of very busy Camden High Street. And there's a group of people trying to get it reopened again as a gay pub. It has been there for years and years and years. And this is the place that I work. I was DJ there for 18 years. And it was a wonderful, wonderful place. But, you know, it's been closed for 2 years. It's probably alive in there now. They'd have to. I expect it's rotten. And it's just such a shame. It really is. If it was to reopen, I'd love to go back there and do karaoke if it ever opened again. I really would.
Picking some of our drag sisters and those who support it on Saturday.
Say that again.
Pity some of our drag family can't go and support them on Saturday afternoon.
Do they not?
None of them. They all say, we really like what you're doing, but they don't go down to go and give their support.
Yeah.
Some of them only live right on the doorstep, you know.
And they live very close there as well, don't they? Yes. I must say, I must say I'd wanted to go down there a few times, but I'm right out here, and you see, if I'm working again in the evening, that's difficult.
I can understand that, but you will give your support where you can.
Oh, yes. You do what you can.
I'm a DJ. It's not mentioning names. People are really close to. They don't seem to care.
No names, darling. No names, right?
I'm not mentioning names.
No, good.
I'm not mentioning names.
Are you on holiday? Are you on holiday at the moment?
No, I just had last week off. I went back to work today.
Okay, and you work at Morrison's. Tell us what you do.
Yeah. I work at a bread and cakes pre-pack.
Bread and cakes. And whenever you come into Central Station, you bring me a little box of cakes, don't you? French fancies.
But they're
French fancies, aren't they? My favourite ones, I like the pink ones best.
And we all like pink ones.
Do you know what?
That's our favourite.
I don't know why they make the chocolate ones. No one seems to want the chocolate ones. Have you noticed that?
I've noticed that. And how's Katie?
Oh, Katie, she's getting on a bit now, and she walks around in circles a lot and meows a lot. I don't think she's too well, really. I don't think there's anything minor wrong with her, like a cold or anything like that. But she's got this little growth on her chin as well that seems to be getting bigger now. Last time I went to the vet, they did notice it, but it's been there a couple of years now. It's just started to grow now. And they did say there wasn't an awful lot they could do, just carry on. And I said to them, she moans a lot, and she goes around in circles, and she walks away from her food. She said, she's allowed to do that because she's so old, you know?
I mean, the other day, I took my friend's dog for a walk.
Yes.
She's about 15, 14 years old, and she looked at me, made a big fuss for her, took some doggy biscuits for her, and she ate the whole packet in one go.
Well, that's not good for them. They eat everything, dogs, you know.
Not all one go, but I hid them, but she found the hiding place. She opened the cupboard with her nose and found them.
Puppies are the worst. They just eat everything. Remote controls, socks and everything. Once, my niece has got this big old soppy dog. I can't remember what type of dog it is anyway. And one day they noticed there was something hanging out of his bum. But it kept running around in circles anyway. They managed to get hold of it in the end, and it was a sock that had gone through its system. Isn't that awful?
Are you there this Friday?
Every Friday, yes. I'm there at Central Station. Every Friday from 8:30 and every Monday from 8 o'clock.
What about, are you doing Kenny Wilde's birthday this year?
I am, yes. And I'm also there roughly every other Saturday. There's a couple of Saturdays in January that are together, but generally it's every other week on a Saturday, but it's every Friday and every Monday, yes.
If I don't see today, I'll come down for Kenny's birthday. We enjoy that.
Okay, Ray. Well, nice to talk to you. Thanks for calling in, my friend, all right? Good luck to you. Bye-bye. There we are. Lovely Ray. He's a lovely chap, he is. Let me just do something. Just send feedback. Send him feedback. Just a second, my darlings. Ray Morrison. How do you spell Morrison? Is it a double R and a double S? I save people's names there so that when they come up, I can tell who's calling. It's all very technical, of course. You can call in yourself if you want to. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number. 020-8144-3477. Skype in if you want to. The Skype in is all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Or you can use the Facebook call-in. Someone used that. We've only had one person ever use that. So you just Facebook call. I'm sure you know how to do it. I don't. No idea how to work any of this stuff. Some more messages coming through this evening, boys and girls. Hello to Elaine once again. Says, gee, does that mean we won't be going out if you come over? Oh, no, Elaine. If I'm on a holiday, that's a different thing altogether, my darling. Very happy to be taken to a bar wherever you are, where you live, or Tel Aviv or somewhere like that when I eventually come back to Israel. And I'll have a little Coca-Cola with you. I tend not to drink. Except on the plane coming over. In those business class seats, you get a lovely glass of champagne. And when you're paying that much for a seat, you might as well get your money's worth, dear. God's sake, don't worry about that, Elaine. Hello to Joanna Evola, who says it's the first time she's caught us live. Yes, just like a fish. And here I am, hanging on the hook, thrashing about for you. Hello, Joanna. Nice to hear you, darling. John says, excess charges. Have you been watching or calling dodgy numbers? No. It was a charity thing. It was I've donated to a charity and I honestly don't know how it's happened. I don't remember dialing this number, but I must have done because it came up when I started putting in the number, you see. Daniel says, I shower in the morning and maybe a shower in the evening. Oh, really? You're that lucky, are you still, Daniel? What, at your age? At your age, dear? Thank you. We've got an email. I must read this email out here. Hello to Chris Lotze, who's in the USA, who says, happy 2017, my friend, and a happy 2017 to you as well, my friend, all right? He says, with the holidays, I fell behind in my United Kingdom talk viewing. Oh, do try and keep... Chris, once you fall behind, it's very, very difficult to catch up again. Maybe I need to take a whole week break to allow people like yourself to catch up on what you don't know what you've missed, do you? You don't know. So I'm now faced with a dilemma. Do I take the time... call in sick from work, tell my children that I can't be bothered with them for the next month so I can sit down and focus on all the episodes I've missed, or do I just move forward and miss out on your past episodes? It's up to you, my friend. You know, if you do miss out on the episodes, if you decide to move on, please don't tell me, you know, because it might hurt me. You might hurt my feelings, Chris. If you decide to just, you know, take a chunk of your life out like that. You know, do bear in mind, if you do decide to move on and you remove a chunk, it will I liken that to being unconscious for a few weeks. You're in years to come, what will happen, Chris? In years to come, you'll be thinking about your past life and there'll be a bit that's missing. Why can't I remember what happened at that part of my life? And it's because you've decided to move on and miss some of the other shows. So be very careful with that. Just be very careful with that, my love. What if you gave something away that I could have won? Well, we might have done that. You know, I don't like to go backwards, my love. I cannot tell you what we did in past shows. What if you gave something away that I could have won? Well, possibly. Like a cheap plastic green London car. Do you know what? No one wanted that. No one's come up to me and said, can I have the cheap plastic green card that you won from a cracker? I carry it around with me to the karaoke on Monday and Fridays. And wait, if you see me anywhere and you come up to me, if you are the first person to say, can I have the cheap green car, then I will give it to you. It's still in my bag. No one has claimed that prize yet. What if you actually told a funny joke? I would miss out on that. What do you mean? I don't tell jokes. We leave that to Simon. He likes to tell the jokes, doesn't he, Simon? He says, so as I try and catch up, I'm currently on Thursday the 29th of December. Good God. What, last year or the year before? He says, you talked about weight loss goals. Oh, yes, we want to lose a stone and a half by the beginning of April. Second week in April. What if instead of a weight loss goals, you focus on something good you were already doing and just improve it? Take the swimming. I don't know how many lengths you do, but what if you increase the lengths by 2 laps a month? It will be easy at first, but as the months pass, you'll be up to Olympic levels. Do you think so? Do you think so? Could I be an Olympic swimmer, possibly? What do you think of that? Could I be the next Tom Daley? It's possible. Anything is possible. Anything is possible. Anything is possible. I can't remember that song now. Can't remember that one. Thank you for the email there, Chris. Do try and catch up, dear. Hello to Joanna. We were talking about gluten-free bread. Now, I eat gluten-free bread at the moment because I thought it was affecting my stomach. Okay? And I was talking to a bloke the other day when I was on my... we was on a night out, all went to Pizza Express in the Strand in London a couple of weeks ago now, just before Christmas it was. And he went gluten-free and he said all his stomach problems cleared up when he started going gluten-free, cut gluten completely out of his diet, which is actually a little bit more difficult than you think. You know, when you're having your bran flakes in the morning, that's got gluten in it. I must say, I'm still having the bran flakes. But the bread I eat now, that's all gluten-free. And I found a type that isn't too bad, actually. I think it's German, Schmoo or something. Hang on, let me see if I can find out what it is for you. Gluten-free bread, I don't know, German? Let's try that. Gluten-free bread, German. Schneider. It's not Schneider. No. There it is. Schar. S-C-H-A-R. Now, that isn't bad. Okay? Still doesn't taste like normal bread, but it's close to it. If you want to try the gluten-free bread, go into... I think this is in Sainsbury's and Waitrose. Schar. S C-H-A-R. I think it's German. Oh, it's got gluten-free gluten-free products. And it comes in like a sealed... That's definitely the one. That's definitely the one, okay? So Shar is the gluten-free bread. S-C-H-A-R is the gluten-free bread that I'm eating. So I'm trying that at the moment to see how it works with my stomach. My stomach, I think, is getting better slowly now. It's starting to get better, but it's by no means okay. Joanna says, Chris, dear, for your information, beware of gluten myths. There is no reason to avoid gluten unless you have a reaction to it. Well, this is what I'm thinking. I keep knocking out items that I eat, hoping that my stomach's going to be better. But of course, nothing's instant, is it, Joanna? You know, you can't give up bread in the morning and by the afternoon your stomach's sorted. You know, it's going to take longer than that. So I think you've got to stick with it to see if it works or not. Joanna says, in fact, gluten may be good for you by reducing your blood pressure and inflammation. Gluten-free doesn't mean healthier. This is what Joanna's saying. Gluten-free foods often have more fat, sugar, and are more expensive than other foods or bread. Oh, well, they're certainly more expensive. Certainly more expensive. That's about £2 for a loaf, and it's not that big. It's not that big. It doesn't taste the same. There's a particular type of bread I like. There's two types of bread that I like, actually. There's Waitrose Boule, I think it is, B-O-U-L-E. I really like that. Now, that one, I know, causes me an acid problem. Oh, it's terrible, the acid. I don't know what they put in that bread, but it's absolutely delicious, but I get terrible acid whenever I have that particular bread. And there's one in Sainsbury's, which is... used to be called tiger, but giraffe bread, they call it now. I think it's giraffe bread. That's really nice. And I like those too. The gluten is, gluten-free is nothing like that. I mean, they taste much better, but I'm trying this at the moment. Joanna says it's from that little thing there is from the Journal of... Also, that gluten-free bread, it does taste sweeter. I must say, it does taste sweeter. So where you're saying that it's got more sugar, I think you're probably right there, yeah. This comes from the Journal of Internal Medicine. Just received my New Year's journal. I have a medical background, so I just wanted to let you know. Hope this helps, but always talk to your doctor. So thank you very much for that. That's very informative. Thank you very, very much for that. Let's have a look here. Mary says, flax seed in breakfast cereal, great for you, fixes tummy problems. What cereal is flax seed in? Is that just like little... Is it seeds? You know, like sunflower seeds, that sort of thing. Is that what flax seeds are? A little bit more info there, please, my lovely Mary. Joanna says, you're better with stoned ground wheat and oat bread. You can get a Hoof health food shop. Oh, well, we have a health food store called... Oh, what are they called now? Big chain of health food store. Health food store. Health food store chain UK. Come on, what was it called? Holland & Barrett. We've got a Holland & Barrett in Bracknell, so I could have a look in there. So thank you for that, my darling. Craig says, Happy New Year. Happy New Year, Craig. Mary says, does done that heart rate app thing you talked about got 30? 40 must be dead. Oh, Mary, have you got 40, Mary? Oh, you can't be doing that right, my love. You can't have 40. Try and have a finger. Select. There's probably no... Have you noticed one of your fingers looks a bit dead? Is it kind of hanging off? Don't use that one, my love. Oh, Mary, one of her fingers is dead. Try one of the other fingers. 40 is... I should go to the doctor with that one. I think anything below 50, below about 45, I'd be worried. So go to the doctor with it. I don't like to worry you, Mary. I can see you tomorrow now, sitting, laying on that doctor's thing, attached to various machines, trying to measure what on earth's going wrong with your 40 beats per minute heart. Very, very worrying. Mark says, I need to start eating good again, keep on track this year. It's so hard, Mark. It's so blooming difficult. You know, you, like me, you're in a pub all the time, surrounded by gorgeous cheese and onion, Walker, crisps and bars of chocolate and nuts. And quite honey nuts drizzled in honey. Even worse. It's so hard, Mike. I know where you are. Kiki D says, check out new bestseller book called Guts by Gwala Enders. Gwala Enders. Gwala Enders. Is that her real name? I wish I could sit down and read a book, Kiki dear. I can't sit down and read a book. I just don't have the patience to read a book. I don't know why. I like reading magazines. Technology magazines I quite like. I used to buy that magazine called Stuff. Do you know Stuff? And it was full of all technology and all that business. I quite like magazines now and again. Hello to Aubrey Dobson, who says, how can you forget Holland & Barrett? I know, Holland & Barrett. And you get some, there's a cheese. There's actually a nice vegan, I'm not vegan, but there's a nice vegan cheese you can buy called, I think it's called High Life. Oh, actually, I think that was in Waitrose, I think, High Life. Something like that. And if you ate it, you would think it tastes like normal cheese. But if you try and grill it on something, it doesn't work. That vegan cheese doesn't work if you try and grill it and you like melt it on a lovely, you know, on a lovely veggie burger or something like that. You know, it doesn't quite work. It kind of goes all funny if you do that. Good Earth. Yeah, thank you. Good Earth. That's another place, isn't it? Good Earth is another place. Yes, I know that one. Yes. So that's that, isn't it? Now, let me see. Oh, okay. Oh, that's a private email there. Private emails coming in as well there. Thanks so much for all your messages yesterday, boys and girls. Let's just read a few of those out from yesterday's show. Joanna also says, we were talking about rap yesterday. Dreadful sort of music, dear. My nephew loves it. Oh, they all the youngsters, they love rap music, don't they? And Joanna says, rap. They have the nerve to call that music. Never. Oh, you're absolutely right. We don't like rap music. Jay thanks you for wishing him happy birthday yesterday. That's okay, Jay. And he's a 34 years old yesterday. We're going to do today's birthdays in a second, boys and girls. Joanna also says, thank you for catching up with my messages. I thought you sang quite well yesterday, especially Motown. Oh, we do like a bit of Motown. We like Motown. And she says, by the way, just before Christmas, we Detroiters, because she's from Detroit, Michigan, US of A, home of the Motor City, Motown. Dedicated, the Detroiters dedicated a main street to the great Stevie Wonder. If that's not good enough, right, wait for this. It was a very special day. Stevie turned up and played several of his songs. Just imagine that, being in the company of the great Stevie Wonder. How fantastic is that, eh? Wow. And Alexander says, oh, Lord, because Alexander, he was the one who rang in yesterday and he swore. Accidentally, he swore. Doesn't matter, but he swore. Anyway, he says, oh, my Lord, I will never call in again. What have I done? You can hear the husband and mum arguing. Thank you for all your professionalism. That's what happens if you call in drunk, my darling. Anyone else want to call in today before we finish up? The phone number is 020-8144-3477. Local London number. You won't be charged premium rate, OK? 020-8144-3477. Or you can use the Facebook call in. Or use Skype. United Kingdom Talk is my Skype in. All right? Joanna says a great ebook by Dr. Furham is by Dr. Furham. It follows a vegetarian diet. As I say, I can't sit down and read a book, unfortunately. I just don't seem to be patient enough to do that. Sorry. All right. Now, here's a little story. Are you wearing... Oh, hang on a minute. Elaine's calling in. Let's have a word with Elaine. Hello, Elaine. How are you, darling? All right?
Hello, my friend. How are you?
Over to Israel. I'm very well. It's going to get very cold here tonight. -6, they're saying. -7.
Oh, it's freezing here now, right now. It's really cold.
I bet it's not. What do you call freezing?
Well, it's about 16 centigrade.
16 centigrade. You think that's freezing? Are you serious?
I know that.
What is the lowest? Does it actually go down to freezing in Israel or not?
Yes, actually, in the mountain areas.
And, oh, yes, of course, yes.
North, it gets like to 1 or -1. Sometimes
of course.
It gets to 0 also.
Yeah. What is that big mountain that I would have gone up? Oh, we went in a cable car up this mountain. I think it was a king.
You went up to Masada.
That's the one. That's the one, Masada. I remember
that's
that.
That's the one near the Dead Sea.
Yes. Oh, it was ever so hot at the top of that. that would have been October, and it was hot on the ground. But we went up this mountain, and it was so hot. And there's nowhere to buy a drink up there until you get back to the eating and drinking area, is there?
Yeah, that's right. Mm. Yeah.
Wonderful little trip that was.
Well, hopefully we'll be able to do it again.
I hope so. Yes, I was a bit scared going up in that cable car, though.
But it was an experience.
Oh, yeah, yeah, absolutely, absolutely. What you been doing, Elaine?
Well, I just wanted to thank you for liking my event on the Barry Manilow special I'm doing at the end of January.
Oh, yes, go on.
Yeah, I'm doing my very first radio show.
How fantastic. And
yes, it is.
What station is that on, Elaine?
Well, it's a local radio station. It's called Radio Nessiona.
Right.
And I posted already the link on Facebook, but I'm going to be doing an hour and a half Barry Manilow special all by myself.
How fantastic. Is that a music show?
Yes, it is. I'm going to be, it's going to be live on radio, and I'm going to do a Facebook feed. And it's going out all over the internet, so all my UK friends can listen to it also. And I'll be introducing Mr. Manilow to the Israeli public.
Oh, well, fantastic.
For those of them who don't know him that much.
Well, I gather Barry was going to do a show in Tel Aviv, but it didn't happen.
Yes,
it was
awful. I had front row seats, Chris.
What happened there then? I don't know.
Well, it was awful. It was such... Well, I've been waiting to see him live for like 30 years or something like that. And when it was announced that he was coming to Israel, there was no one in the universe more happy than I was.
Yes.
And I actually had front row seats. And then a month before the show, the Israeli promoter canceled the show.
Oh,
because
shame.
Because apparently, you know, it's not like the UK where Barry can sell out the O2 in 2 seconds.
Right,
you know?
Okay.
But, you know, there are all sorts of considerations. And I was very, very disappointed.
Yeah.
And I said to myself, well, you know something... I've got to make this happen somehow.
Yes, yeah.
I mean, because the Israeli audience really deserves to see him live on stage.
Do you think maybe the venue might have been too big for there?
Oh, well, I don't know what the considerations was. I don't know. As far as I'm concerned, you know, he can fill out any arena he wants to.
Yeah,
but,
of course.
You know, I don't know what the considerations were. But in any case, you know, you've seen him live, so...
Yes, many times.
You know what I'm talking about, right?
Many times. I'm very, very lucky to have seen him so many times. Not as many as a lot of what I like to call the Manilow girls. But certainly, you know, I mean, it's just wonderful to go and see him live. It really is. Listen, tell me a little bit about this little radio station. Is it a community station? I mean, how is it, like a town or a province or what?
It's a local radio station that works under the auspices of the municipality of Netziona.
Right.
And the radio, they operate a radio station. It's like a college radio station, you know. It's part of their media studies program.
Okay.
And they have an oldie show that they play once a week.
Right.
So, well, it's very interesting how it came about, because the guy who runs the radio, who runs the oldie show, went to see the Air Supply concert when Air Supply was here in Israel.
I'm all out of love.
I saw them when they were here first few years ago. Yeah, they were awesome. Just awesome.
Oh, wow.
Have you ever seen them in concert?
I haven't, no, but I love their music. I love that stuff.
Oh, yeah, they are all out of love. In concert. They've been here like 4 times already.
Anyway. All Out of Love is my favourite song. And there's another one that's like that. What's the other song that's like that?
To Us Lonely People, Even the Nights Are Better.
Oh, I can't remember now.
So many.
Yeah. Air Supply.
Yeah, Every Woman in the World. They have such great songs. Yeah.
There's another one that I really like.
So he went to see them in Tel Aviv, and he's telling on Facebook what a wonderful concert it was and all that. So I write him on the Facebook page, and I said, look, what a shame, you know, like Barry Manilow's concert was canceled. And he writes me back and says, you know something, I think I have an idea how to make it happen. He said to me, "What? How would you feel about like co-hosting a Barry Manilow special, like to reintroduce
him to
the Israeli crowd?"
Wonderful.
And I said, "Are you kidding me?"
So you'll be playing Barry songs right the way through, will you?
Absolutely, an hour and a half.
Oh, wonderful! Will you just be playing them or talking about them as well?
No, I'll be, and it's going to be in English.
Right, okay.
Not in Hebrew. It's going to be in English. And
Do they have English-speaking stations in Israel, do you? Probably in Tel Aviv?
No, actually. But most of the stations are in Hebrew.
Right, okay.
But this one, he wants to give it an international flavor, so that's why it's going to be in English.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And,
when is it?
I'm going to be playing the songs, and I'm going to be like telling a little Barry trivia and, you know, telling little tidbits about the songs and all that.
Yeah.
It's going to be very, very interesting.
When is it, Elaine?
31st of January.
31st of January. Now, I'm going to put this on my calendar, actually. Yeah. So, and what time? Do you know what time?
It's 6 p.m. Israel, which is 4 p.m. UK.
Are you sure about that? So... Is it now? Hang on. Is it now? Is it now 10 to 11 where you are?
We're 2 hours ahead of you.
So it's 10 to 11, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Right, okay. So that's 4 p.m. on the 31st, you said, did you?
Yeah.
And what's that station? What did you say that station name was?
It's called the Colnessiona, and I'll send you the link on the Facebook.
Oh, yes, okay.
Right? Like you'll see the event page. You already liked it, so you have the link already.
Lovely. Okay. 4 p.m. Barry's show, Elaine. Oh, well, funny. How lucky are you to be able to do that? I've done some music radio myself, but not recently. I kind of gave up the music shows for the chat. I found us was talking more and more between the records. So eventually I just gave up the records altogether. And we did have the daily Manilow moment on my show. Well, we'd always play a Barry song there. Oh, you'll have a one. It's so much fun. Will people be able to call in or not?
No.
Oh, that's a shame.
But I am planning to have a special guest, and it's going to be a surprise.
Yeah, lovely.
And it's not Barry.
Is Barry actually going to make an appearance at the... Maybe you'd be on the air and suddenly he just appears.
Yeah,
I mean,
right.
I feel myself getting closer to him. I mean, I've now got a piece of paper on my wall that he has actually touched with his signature. I mean, how close is that?
Goodness.
Closer and closer.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, well, the possibility of that happening is the same as the possibility of Her Majesty waiting to call into your show.
Oh, she's not well at the moment. She's got a heavy cold. They still...
Oh, I hope she's okay.
Well, she's still got a heavy cold. My guess is...
We really love the royal family here.
Yes, as I do. I think she's probably got a touch of pneumonia. I reckon because it's been a long time.
I hope she gets better. We really like her over here.
Yeah, but she will get the best treatment and all that, and hopefully she'll pull through all right there.
Yeah, I'm sure she will. I really like that you like my event. Do you have any tips for me? Any advice?
Yes. If I just say to you, how's it go now? Fail to prepare, and you will prepare to fail. So in the coming weeks, just write down some bits that perhaps you want to say before the song and give yourself an exit line. It doesn't really work on the talking radio like I'm doing here, talking telly or whatever you want to call it, talking computer. But so for example, you could be saying, Mandy, which you released in 1972. And then you push the button and the song starts. Otherwise, what you can find happens, and all you need is that exit line. And perhaps lines on a piece of paper of stuff that you want to say. Now, I've got written down here, for example, you heard my story about the mobile phones, yeah?
Yes.
Right. So all I've got down written on this piece of paper, okay, is £10 charge, 3 excellent, good or bad experience of mobile phone. That's all I've got written down. And yet, how long was I talking about that? 10 minutes? Something like
yeah,
that?
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, if it's music radio, you don't need to talk anywhere near as much as I do. But I would write down an exit line, the last line that you're going to say before you hit the button. Because otherwise, what can happen, I think, is that you find yourself rambling on and you don't know where to come out.
And I really don't want to do that.
No, do you see what I mean? And also, remember, you'll have a list of records that you want to play and you need to make sure that you can fit them all in. Because if you talk too much on music radio, you will find you get to, and you haven't played 5 or 6 records, and you're, oh, damn. You know, I wanted to play those records. So do your preparation. Perhaps each song that you want to play, generally musicians, when they write a song, it means something to them. You know, they're not just randomly writing down lyrics. It means something to them. So he wrote the song, This One's For You. What was that about? And perhaps that could be the bit of talking that you play, and then you've got the exit line, and then you play the song. This one's for you, wherever you are. Obviously, I recommend if you're playing Barry songs, perhaps not sing over them, my love.
oh, no, not me.
As
no.
We all do at the concerts, don't we? So that's all I'd say to you. You know, try and perhaps have timings and that. And maybe if you want to go one stage further, have on that piece of paper the timings where you want the song to start so that it fits into the hour. So presumably they have the news, don't they?
No, actually, no.
Oh, you don't have the news. So you would start...
It's a full netto 90 minutes.
Right, okay.
With no breaks.
Okay, so you start bang on 6 o'clock. So you'd have on your bit of paper, 6 p.m., say hello, welcome to the Barry Show. I'm going to play you blah, 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 lots of Barry music today. I fell in love with Barry and da-da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da. Here's the first song written by da-da-da-da-da. It means to him da-da-da-da-da. And it's called Copacabana. Bang. Boom, 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 Copacabana. And then after the song, repeat. That was Copacabana. And then into the next one, a little bit like that. Do you have adverts?
No.
No. No, okay. I mean, I don't know how far into it that you'd want to do, but normal radio stations, they would have like a piece of paper in front of them, like 6 p.m., 1800 hours, talk. 1801, play record. 1803 and 40 seconds, talk. I mean, that's what they do. Mm. I don't think you'd need to do it that strictly. If you see what I mean. But you could do it more loosely, sort of at 6 o'clock, talk, 5 past 6, first record, 8 minutes past 6, talk. And then if you was to do it like that, you can keep an eye on the clock, and then you would make sure that you can play all your songs.
Okay.
I personally do it, I would, if I was still doing music radio, I would do it loosely. But then I found, Elaine, that I just rabbited on so much. Sometimes there was only time for half a song in the whole show.
Oh, my.
Anyway, my dear, lovely to talk to you, Elaine.
Yeah, lovely to talk to you too. Thank you so much, Chris.
You make sure you post that thing on my wall when you're going to do it as well. I won't be around at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I'm usually it's on a Tuesday, isn't it?
Tuesday, right.
Generally, at 4 o'clock, I'm asleep. So there we are.
Oh well. In any case, they're also going to have. It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon, Chris.
Right. Right, yeah. Okay.
You're asleep at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Good for you.
Yeah, I could just have my computer recording that, you see. I could have it recording it.
Okay. And probably the day after, they'll have a link to the podcast.
So that's even better. Yeah, that's even better. Yeah. A lot of podcasts are downloaded now. People have at last got used to that idea that you can hear a show afterwards. All right?
Yeah. Well, thanks, Chris. Have a very, very good evening. It was lovely to talk to you.
Lovely to talk to you, Elaine. Take care in your 16 degrees of winter weather. You lucky thing. Cheerio now.
Thanks. Good night.
Bye-bye. Elaine calling in from Israel there. Those of you watching the live show, I think you might have lost us for a second or two then. Did you lose us for a couple of seconds? Because it came up that one piece of the software failed, but it's... kind of restarted itself, so hopefully you're with us again. Did you lose us for a couple of seconds there? I don't know. Some of your messages coming through. Sarita says, there are more items in the background. I feel like I've missed a lot. You have missed a lot, Sarita. You've missed an awful lot, dear. Do pay full attention. Anne says, yes, you were cut off, but we're back now, so that's good. How long did it cut off for? What happened on my computer screen in front of me? It said the software had disconnected. It was trying to reconnect. And then it said reconnection successful. So I don't think you actually lost the show completely. It carried on, but you couldn't see me. Is that right? Could you actually hear anything? How interesting that is. Oh, 20 seconds. And you stayed with us. Oh, you're so lovely. You really are. You stayed with us. Thank you very much. Mark, have a nice time at your karaoke. All right. Thank you, Anne. Anne's with us today. Hello, Anne. All right, darling. Let's see. Adam the plumber's with us as well. You're a bit late, Adam. We're nearly finished now, dear. Nearly finished, I'm afraid. Mark says the Queen is better now. Oh, that's good news, Mark. Yeah, we're all a bit concerned about the good old Queen, aren't we? We love Queen Elizabeth. We do indeed. Kiki D says you won't see illustrations how to sit when doing a... Please, Kiki D, I can't read that out, my darling. John says, how much to hire Barry to appear on your show? I would never be able to afford that. He wouldn't want to come here. It's a little show with just, you know, a handful of people joining in, isn't it? I don't think Barry would want to come here, my dear. Craig says, rap is crap. I'm young, but I love the music from the 1950s right up to today, but only a certain few new artists. I know what you mean. Mark also says, did Jimmy get up in the end after his New Year's Eve antics? Yeah, he got up about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. That's my nephew, Jimmy. He went out New Year's Eve and... I don't think they got in till very, very late, him and his girlfriend, and they didn't get up till about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Terrible. Terrible, terrible, terrible. And the Queen did her first engagement today. So that's good news. It looks like she's all better. Oh, that is good news. Anyway, we're going to finish off now, boys and girls. It's time to do today's birthdays. Now, I believe it's one of my friend's birthdays, Kelly Wilde. She also, I do some work for her as well. She's an agent. I work for her. She's a entertainment agent. Now, her birthday hasn't come up on my birthday list, but I kept seeing little flashes of people wishing her happy birthday. So it must be her birthday today. So happy birthday to the lovely Kelly Wilde. Nearly didn't quite make it, but she nearly got in to represent us for the Eurovision Song Contest one year. She was in the national final, you know, where they have that thing and you choose a song to go through. Years ago, this is, but she didn't quite get through. But that doesn't matter. And she's an all-round entertainer, cabaret singing. And there's not a single night that I've worked with Kelly where she has not got the crowd going, whether it's big or small. She always gets full of energy. Happy birthday, Kelly Wilde, all right? Happy birthday also today to Jon Wells, who's 28 today. Happy birthday, John. Happy birthday to Shaun Furmston, DJ Sean. Hello, Sean. Years since I saw you, isn't it? I gather you did New Year's Eve as well, so well done with that one. Happy birthday, Sean. And happy birthday today to Wayne Crombie, who's 42 years old on this Wednesday. Happy birthday to you all. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right, gang? I know it's a little bit late, but enjoy the rest of your birthday. And that's it from the show today, boys and girls. I'll just check any more messages to read out before I disappear. No, that's it today. Thank you very, very much for all your messages today. Absolutely, it's really nice being able to sometimes to sit here and do a live show now and again. I know we've done a lot recently, but I've had quite a bit of time off since the New Year's. And I've actually got the weekend off as well, so we'll do some more at the weekend. Might try a morning one. I haven't tried a morning live show yet, so we might do that as well at some point. Enjoy the rest of your Wednesday, isn't it? Enjoy the rest of your Wednesday, whatever you're doing. Thanks for watching and listening. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye now.